Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Imran Chonara, African Muslims Agency. Right now, the world is witnessing the mass destruction of life and intense suffering caused by the ongoing fighting in Afghanistan. Innocent human beings caught in the crossfire. Thousands of families are displaced. African Muslims Agency teams are on the ground right now, assisting through shelter, through food, through medicine, helping the injured. Many, many, many children are left without parents. Support the African Muslims Agency campaign to heal Afghanistan.
يوم تشقق الأرض عنهم سراعا ذلك حشر علينا يسير نحن أعلم بما يقولون وما أنت عليهم بجبار فذكر بالقرآن من يخاف وعيد بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إذا وقعت الواقعة ليس لوقعتها كاذبة خافضة رافعة إذا رجت الأرض رجا وبست الجبال بسا فكانت هباء منبثا وكنتم أزواجا ثلاثة فأصحاب الميمنة ما أصحاب الميمنة وأصحاب المشأمة ما أصحاب المشأمة والسابقون السابقون أولئك المقربون في جنات النعيم ثلة من الأولين وقليل من الآخرين على سرر موضونة متكئين عليها متقابلين يطوف عليهم ولدان مخلدون بأكواب وأباريق وكأس من معين لا يصدعون عنها ولا ينزفون وفاكهة مما يتخيرون ولحم طير مما يشتهون وحور عين كأمثال اللؤلؤ المكنون جزاء بما كانوا يعملون لا يسمعون فيها لغوا ولا تأثيما إلا قيلا سلاما سلاما وأصحاب اليمين ما أصحاب اليمين في سدر مخضود وطلح منضود وظل ممدود وماء مسكوب وفاكهة كثيرة لا مقطوعة ولا ممنوعة وفرش مرفوعة إنا أنشأناهن إنشاء فجعلناهن أبكارا عربا أترابا لأصحاب اليمين ثلة من الأولين وثلة من الآخرين وأصحاب الشمال ما أصحاب الشمال في سموم وحميم وظل من يحموم لا بارد ولا كريم إنهم كانوا قبل ذلك مترفين وكانوا يصرون على الحنث العظيم وكانوا يقولون أإذا متنا وكنا ترابا وعظاما أإنا لمبعوثون أو آباؤنا الأولون قل إن الأولين والآخرين لمجموعون إلى ميقات يوم معلوم ثم إنكم أيها الضالون المكذبون لآكلون من شجر من زقوم فمالئون منها البطون فشاربون عليه من الحميم فشاربون شرب الهين هذا نزلهم يوم الدين نحن خلقناكم فلولا تصدقون أفرأيتم ما تمنون أأنتم تخلقونه أم نحن الخالقون نحن قدرنا بينكم الموت وما نحن بمسبوقين على أن نبدل أمثالكم وننشئكم فيما لا تعلمون ولقد علمتم النشأة الأولى فلولا تذكرون أفرأيتم ما تحرثون أأنتم تزرعونه أم نحن الزارعون لو نشاء لجعلناه حطاما فظلتم تفكهون إنا لمغرمون بل نحن محرومون أفرأيتم الماء الذي تشربون أأنتم أنزلتموه من المزن أم نحن المنزلون لو نشاء جعلناه أجاجا فلولا تشكرون أفرأيتم النار التي تورون أأنتم أنشأتم شجرتها أم نحن المنشئون نحن جعلناها تذكرة ومتاعا للمقوين فسبح باسم ربك العظيم فلا أقسم بمواقع النجوم وإنه لقسم لو تعلمون عظيم إنه لقرآن كريم في كتاب مكنون لا يمسه إلا المطهرون تنزيل من رب العالمين أفبهذا الحديث أنتم مدهنون وتجعلون رزقكم أنكم تكذبون فلولا إذا بلغت الحلقوم وأنتم حينئذ تنظرون ونحن أقرب إليه منكم ولكن لا تبصرون فلولا إن كنتم غير مدينين ترجعونها إن كنتم صادقين فأما إن كان من المقربين فروح وريحان وجنة نعيم وأما إن كان من أصحاب اليمين فسلام لك من أصحاب اليمين وأما إن كان من المكذبين الضالين فنزل من حميم وتصلية جحيم إن هذا لهو حق اليقين فسبح باسم ربك العظيم. صدق الله العظيم.
اللهم صل على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا ومولانا محمد وأصحابه وبارك وسلم. My dearly beloved Jamaatul Muslimin, respected elders, mothers and fathers, brothers and sisters, greet you with the universal greetings of peace on this lovely, beautiful day of Jum'ah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah, it gives me great pleasure indeed on this beautiful, auspicious day of Jum'ah to present to you our guest for today, none other than Maulana Ahmad Aku from Pietermaritzburg, from Madrasa At-Tartil, and we have received Maulana on the high recommendation of Maulana Muhammad Wenke from Durban, and he sends his salams to the Jamaat. And without further ado, I call upon our honorable guest, Maulana Ahmad Aku, to kindly address us. فليتفضل مشكورا يا فضيلة الشيخ.
الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وبارك وسلم تسليما كثيرا كثيرا أما بعد فقد قال الله تبارك وتعالى في القرآن المجيد بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم أحسب الناس أن يتركوا أن يقولوا آمنا وهم لا يفتنون ولقد فتن الذين من قبلهم فليعلمن الله الذين صدقوا وليعلمن الكاذبين صدق الله العظيم وبلغنا رسوله النبي الكريم ونحن على ذلك من الشاهدين والشاكرين والحمد لله رب العالمين Respected brothers and sisters, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته All praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Peace and salutations be upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. All praise and thanks is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for each and every favor that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed us with. We praise and thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for blessing us with another beautiful day of Jumu'ah, the first of Rabi'ul Awwal, this blessed month in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the blessed Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam into this world. And for me, it is a great honor to stand before you today, mashallah, in this absolutely beautiful house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We make dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless each and every one of us with goodness. When we reflect over the past 16 or 17 months or the last 2 years or life in general, what we notice is that whether we like it or not, life has become absolutely unpredictable. Nobody knows what tomorrow is going to bring. We've been through the first wave, we've been through the second wave, we've been through the third wave. Now there's talks and predictions of the fourth one, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best what the future holds. But in essence, every single person in some way or the other has been tested by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Some have been tested on many fronts. Some are facing challenges that they never foresaw that they would be facing in life in this world. Today's topic is the greater the vision, the more the ability to withstand difficulty and hardship. The greater the goal a person has, the more you have the ability to withstand difficulty and hardship on that very same path. Let's take a simple analogy. When we take a young kid and we look at a child in school that has a vision and a goal ahead of them, that I need to be successful in life. I want to walk a certain path in life. I want to become a doctor. I want to become a lawyer. I want to achieve something in life. Then there's a great goal and vision ahead of that young child. So that child is able to withstand the difficulty of examinations. That child is able to withstand the difficulty of staying awake late at night studying, because the child has a goal and vision ahead of them. Take Another example, when we start off, for example, in business, so we have a goal, we have a vision ahead of us, we want to achieve something, we want to establish a business, we want to establish a practice, we have a goal, we have a vision, we're able to withstand so many difficulties, so many hours standing on your feet, so much of hardship, so much of effort you put in, you're able to withstand every challenge that comes your way because you have a vision ahead of you and you have a goal ahead of you. Exactly the same is with every aspect of our life. When we look at the challenges that life has thrown at us and we look at the hardships and difficulties that we're facing, then that is the time that we need to remind ourselves, what is my vision? What is my goal? Where am I headed towards? There's a beautiful, simple example that I've come across in further explaining this topic. And they say that if two people set out on a journey and one person just has a 5-hour journey or travel ahead of him, and the second person has to travel for 3 days. So the question that they ask is that after 5 hours, who do you think is going to be more tired? Who you think is going to experience fatigue? Is it the person that has come to the end of their 5-hour journey, or is it the person that is traveling for 3 days? And they say that naturally and amazingly, a person that's just traveled for 5 hours, he's automatically tired or she's tired. You need to stretch, you need to relieve yourself, you need to relax, the body is sore, the back is paining, but you've just traveled for 5 hours. But leave 5 hours, 15 hours later, ask the person that has a 3-day journey ahead of them, whether they tired. They're not tired, they're as fresh as ever, but it's 3 times more the time than the person who traveled for 5 hours. The greater the vision, the more the ability to withstand difficulty and hardship. Now take that example of two people traveling. Every single one of us are traveling through this dunya, through this world. What we need to ask ourselves is, which journey are we on? Have we come to only live in this world, or have we come for a greater purpose? Do we have a longer journey? When does our journey stop? It doesn't stop the day our eyes close in this world. In fact, that's the time it actually really starts. We visited the graveyard how many times in our life? Have we ever looked at those tombstones? A person born in the year 1930, he passed away in the year 1965. Only 35 years he lived above the surface of the earth. And what's the year now? 2021. How long have they spent beneath the surface of this earth? So leave a 3-day journey, we still have a very long journey ahead of us. We've got the whole period of time that we will spend beneath the surface of the earth. We have the time that we will have to stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The greater the vision, the more the ability to withstand difficulty and hardship. And today is the first of Rabi al-Awwal. This is the month where we will hear a lot about the life of the Blessed Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Who's the man that had the greatest vision? Who's the man that had the greatest goal? It was none other than Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Recite the brothers. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala Ali Muhammad. So he's the man that had the greatest goal and the greatest vision. And do you know who's the man that experienced the most amount of difficulty in the history of humanity? Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, لَقَدْ أُوذِيتُ فِي اللَّهِ. I've been made to go through difficulties and hardship in this world more than any other person in the history of humanity. That is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the man with the greatest goal and the greatest vision, and he's the one that went through the greatest difficulty. When you think it's too hard for you to go on, when you feel that the pain is unbearable, people have suffered different challenges in their lives in this world. Some maybe have suffered sickness, others may have suffered loss of income, some may have lost their job, somebody may have lost their child, somebody may have lost their parent, somebody may have lost their sibling, some may have lost multiple loved ones in their life, and you're feeling the pain within you and you're wondering that, how long more must I endure this pain? How can I go on? How can I move forward? If you're in that position, you just need to take one moment to sit, reflect and ponder over the life of the Blessed Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. If you think we going through trying times now, then we really need to reflect over the life of the Blessed Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. I want to take you through one passage of the life of the Blessed Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, where you see multiple challenges and difficulties one after the other in the life of the Blessed Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And when you look at those challenges, you wonder, how was it possible for this man to go through so much of difficulty? How was it possible for this man to endure so much of hardship? But what is our topic? Let's keep reminding ourselves of that. That the greater the goal, the more the ability to withstand difficulty and hardship. So we know that in the time of the Blessed Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, there was the period of the boycott. We've only experienced lockdown, and lockdown comes with its restrictions, but more or less life is pretty normal on many aspects. So you lock down or you restricted, but you still have access for a certain amount of time. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his entire family and anybody that supported his cause, all of them were boycotted for how long? For 1 month, for 2 months, for 1 year? They were boycotted for 3 years, unbroken. So if you thought level 5 was hard, can you imagine a total boycott? You are absolutely banished from society. Nobody is allowed to interact with you. Nobody is allowed to do business with you. Nobody is allowed to talk to you. Nobody is allowed to come close to you for a period of 3 years. You're made to live in a valley. They starved. They had to boil the leaves of trees to survive. The cries of the pangs of hunger of the children of the believers were echoing through the streets of Makkatul Mukarrama. For how long? For 3 years. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that there were times where I endured such hunger and starvation. The only thing I could eat was that which Bilal radiallahu anhu managed to hide under his arm, a little bit of food. He would come and he would share that with me. So much of difficulty, so much of hardship. And one would think that after 3 years of so much of difficulty and hardship, maybe now there's going to be light at the end of this tunnel. Maybe now the rainbow is going to come. Conditions are going to change. What happens immediately after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam emerges from this boycott? Immediately thereafter, he loses his two greatest supporters, his uncle Abu Talib and his beloved wife, our mother Ummahatul Mu'mineen, Khadija radiallahu anha. He's dealt with those two extremely heavy blows. After when? After coming out of 3 years of difficulty and hardship. And you might think that, why isn't the condition changing? How can you suffer so much of difficulty after 3 years of hardship? You lose your two greatest supporters. And if you think it ended there, no, it never ended there. Immediately thereafter, what happens in the life of the Blessed Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? He turns his attention and focus to Taif. How many times we've heard of that incident? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam goes there with so much of hope, with so much of ambition, that if the people of Makkah are not prepared to support me and listen to my message, let me reach out to others. And he goes to Taif, and that becomes one of the most difficult days in his entire life. He is stoned, he is ridiculed, he is verbally abused, his body is bleeding, he's finished, he is totally, totally humiliated. After how much of difficulty? 3 years of the boycott, then you lose your two greatest supporters. And now you go through this, how is it that this man never cave in? How is it that he never give up? How is it that he never just lose all hope and say that, Ya Allah, how much more must I take? The greater the goal, the greater the ability to withstand difficulty and hardship. This was Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He had a goal ahead of him. He had a vision ahead of him. He was on a mission. He had a job to do. So he was able to withstand all those difficulties and hardships. And in fact, at that moment, after the incident of Taif, the manner alone in which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam turned to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that can be a whole discussion on its own. Because one would naturally think that after so much of difficulty, he would lift his hands up and he would say, Ya Allah, enough is enough. How much more must I take? I'm a human being after all. How much more pain must I suffer? But the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam lifts up his hands and he says, Allahumma ilayka ashku du'fa quwwati. Oh Allah, I'm lifting my hands up and I'm telling you that maybe I couldn't do enough. It's through my weakness that these people never listen to my message. That's how he turned to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But for you and I, when it becomes too painful, when it becomes unbearable, when we feel that we can't go further, when we feel that it's too much, then there's absolutely nothing wrong. In fact, that's what we're supposed to do. We're supposed to lift our hands up and say that, oh Allah, we weak. We unable to withstand this. We can't do it alone, oh Allah. We need you with us. We need you to remove the difficulties, challenges and hardships. Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Asalullah al-afiyah. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for ease. Don't ever ask to be tested by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But if you are tested by Him, then you need to know with absolute certainty that Allah loves you tremendously. That is why He is testing you. Because the one that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loved the most was who? Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And who is the man that was tested the most? Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. An absolutely crystal clear sign of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's love upon you. I often say this, especially to people who've lost children and lost kids, and they're grieving and they're heartbroken and they're shattered. When I go to meet them, I tell them that there's one thing you need to take consolation in, and that is the fact that me as an individual, I'm speaking about myself, I'm still struggling. I don't know what is going to be my position before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I'm aiming to attain the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But one thing I can tell you for sure is that Allah loves you more than you can imagine. One thing I can tell you, your job is done, because you've suffered such a loss that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the only befitting compensation from Allah is Jannah and paradise for you. So while I'm struggling, I can tell you with absolute certainty, you sorted out in the midst of your pain and in the midst of your difficulty. And like that, any other challenge that we suffer, can you imagine? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that even if a thorn has to prick you in this world, that amount of discomfort, what's a thorn prick? It's like, ouch, just 1 second of discomfort. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that that is a means of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgiving you and removing your sins, and Allah elevating your ranks with the slightest amount of discomfort. Can you imagine those that are really going through pain? Can you imagine those that are really suffering, that are going through so much of hardship? Through this entire pandemic, there are people that were struggling to breathe. People have no energy to go on. People have been suffering so much of difficulty and hardship non-stop for a period of time. If the lightest discomfort is a means of Allah elevating your ranks and granting you forgiveness, then can you imagine those that are going through constant difficulty? And again, another consolation for them. Remember, the greater the goal, the greater the ability to withstand difficulty and hardship. Let's go back to the example I cited a few minutes ago about the two people on two different journeys, one on a 5-hour journey, one on a 3-day journey. We have a long road ahead of us. So for those people that are feeling the road too long and the pain too much, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that on the day of Qiyamah, the most fortunate person to have ever lived in this world, a person who from the time they entered this dunya till the day they exited it had nothing but goodness in their life. They never had a moment of hardship, a moment of difficulty. They will be brought forth and they will be put in the fire of Jahannam just for the blink of an eye. For one split second, they will be put in and taken out. And what's the question that will be posed to them? Yabna Adam hal ra'ayta khayrun qattu. O son of Adam, have you ever experienced goodness in your existence? Have you ever had a good existence from the time you were created till today? And that person will say, La. By the qasam of Allah, I've never experienced 1 second of goodness. A man whose entire life was blessed, a man whose entire existence, he never felt any difficulty. For 1 second, he's put in the fire of Jahannam, and it eradicates a lifetime of goodness. But the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that at the same time, on the day of Qiyamah, the most unfortunate person that ever lived in this dunya, the person whose entire existence was riddled with challenges, difficulties, hardships and pain, I ask you to be true to yourself. Many of us are going through challenges. Some of us are going through a lot of pain. But have you had constant difficulty from the time you were born till today? No, we've had so many good moments. We have so many positive things to look forward to. We have so much to be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for, despite the challenges and difficulties that we face. But here the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is talking about a person whose entire life was riddled with challenges. He will be brought forth and he will be put into Jannah for the blink of an eye. 1 split second. The clock is ticking before us. 1 second, how long does it take? He will be put into paradise, he will be taken out. And the question that will be posed to him, Yabna Adam hal ra'ayta sharrun qattu. O son of Adam, have you ever experienced pain? Have you ever experienced any difficulty? And the response will be, La. By the qasam of Allah, I've never experienced a moment's of pain or a moment of grief, 1 second in paradise is enough to eradicate a lifetime of misery. That's what we're looking forward to, a life of eternity. That Jannah is going to be forever and ever. You might be separated from your loved one in this world, but you will be reunited forever and ever. You might be going through difficulty now, but you will experience goodness, happiness and joy forever and ever. You will attain the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's the journey you and I are on. And the greater the goal, the more the ability to withstand difficulty and hardship. So whenever you feel life perhaps is being unfair to you, whenever you feel that now this is too much for me, ask yourself, what is my goal? What is my vision? Where am I headed towards? And once you remind yourself of that, you also need to reflect on the life of the Blessed Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the man with the greatest goal, with the greatest vision, and the person that went through the greatest amount of difficulty and hardship. He was able to withstand all those challenges because of his goal, because of his vision. You and I need to have that goal and vision, and that is to attain the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that is also to walk in the footsteps of the Blessed Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So tomorrow when we stand before Allah, we can say that, oh Allah, I tried, I wanted to please you, I did whatever I could. Oh Allah, I hope you've accepted my effort and I've attained your pleasure and attained the paradise that you have prepared for each and every believer. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from those fortunate ones, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remove the difficulties and challenges and hardships that people are facing. But that's our message for today, which we need to share with everyone. What is your goal? What is your vision? Because the greater that goal, the more the ability to withstand difficulty and hardship. And someone said it very nicely. They said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's timing is perfect in every matter. We don't always understand the wisdom behind it, but what we need to do is we need to learn to trust it. This is the decision of Allah. Allah is in complete control. He knows what's best for us, when it is best for us. We might think we know better, but never forget Allah is always in charge. He's in supreme control, and we need to learn to trust that control of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.
Takbir. Allahu akbar wa lillahi alhamd. Shukran, jazakallah khair, and baitra makasi for Maulana Ahmad Aku from Madrasatul Tartil in Pietermaritzburg, who is here on a short holiday with his family. May Almighty Allah bless you and your loved ones, and may you have a good time here in Cape Town, inshallah. And may Allah grant us a capacity of understanding this very inspirational message today, that we need to set high goals, high aspirations for ourselves, and strive towards the pleasure of Almighty God, Allah Azza wa Jal. Jazakallah khair, Mawlana, and it is indeed a pleasure to have had you here today to grace us with your presence. We would like to thank Hafiz Meyer Diedrichs for the beautiful tilawat he has rendered before the talk. And an announcement from SA Maulud, they announced that they will be having their annual Mass Maulud on Saturday the 16th of December at the Habibia Masjid Complex, inshallah, and everyone is welcome. Also, last but not least, I once again want to remind you that we have asked all the wives and all the women to close their kitchens at home on the 31st of October and asked our husbands to kindly come and bring you here to Masjid Al-Quds to join us in a family fun day. We will have a walk, a fun walk the morning. We will have other activities. Breakfast will be available. Lunch will be on purchase. It is a family fun day, inshallah, to help and assist in giving therapy to our community who has been through the hard times of COVID-19. Wallahi, at the moment, I'm still counseling people and I'm running a new class called Life and Death, the journey to Allah, how to deal with trauma and how to find closure on sudden death of loved ones. So our community has got a lot of trauma that they have faced. May Almighty Allah remove COVID-19 from planet Earth. Ameen Ya Rabbal Alameen. And may Allah safeguard us and keep us in His divine protection and preservation, because we need to understand that even though the country was put on alert level 1, it does not mean COVID-19 is gone. It is still here amongst us. Please, I beg each and every one of us to maintain our COVID protocols. Keep your distance, your social and physical distance. Wear your mask, especially when you're out in public and in gatherings, and always sanitize. Look after yourself and simultaneously place your trust in Allah. For those who place their trust in Allah and they take the necessary precaution, like the Prophet said to the one Sahabi, first tie your camel and then you put your trust in Allah. So let us tie our camel by taking our necessary precaution, put our trust in Allah, and Allah will preserve us. Ameen ya Rabbal Alameen. May Allah grant us all the blessings and the barakah of Jum'ah, as well as this great and auspicious month of Mawlud Sharif, Rabiul Awwal. May Allah bless us all. Ameen ya Rabbal Alameen. Maulana will also make the 2 khutbas on the mimbar, and the request was for Hafiz Yasin Roiker to lead the salah for Jummah. Our young son, who 2 weeks ago led the salah till Jummah in Maldives. Alhamdulillah, he's back, and the request is for him to lead the salah today at Masjid al-Quds. Shukran, we'll have the first adhan and then the sunnahs, and then the second adhan and the khutbas, inshallah. Shukran, Paitra Makasi.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وعدل الشرك والمشركين رب اهتمنا بخير برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين والحمد لله رب العالمين. اللهم أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله.
الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له، ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وبارك وسلم تسليمًا كثيرًا كثيرًا. أما بعد، فقد قال الله تبارك وتعالى في القرآن المجيد بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: أحسب الناس أن يتركوا أن يقولوا آمنا وهم لا يفتنون، ولقد فتنا الذين من قبلهم فليعلمن الله الذين صدقوا وليعلمن الكاذبين. وقال تعالى: أم حسبتم أن تدخلوا الجنة ولما يأتكم مثل الذين خلوا من قبلكم مستهم البأساء والضراء وزلزلوا حتى يقول الرسول والذين آمنوا معه متى نصر الله؟ ألا إن نصر الله قريب. وقال تعالى: ولنبلونكم بشيء من الخوف والجوع ونقص من الأموال والأنفس والثمرات وبشر الصابرين الذين إذا أصابتهم مصيبة قالوا إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون. وقال عليه الصلاة والسلام: من أحب سنتي فقد أحبني، ومن أحبني كان معي في الجنة، أو كما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. بارك الله لنا ولكم في القرآن العظيم، ونفعنا وإياكم بالآيات والذكر الحكيم، إنه تعالى جواد كريم ملك بر الرب الرؤوف الرحيم.
اللهم صل وسلم وزد وتوانم وتفضل وبارك بجلالك وكمالك على زين عبادك واشرف نبارك سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى ال سيدنا محمد وصحبه وسلم سلم ورضي الله تبارك وتعالى عن كل صحابه اجمعين.
الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له، ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمدًا عبده ورسوله أرسله بالحق بشيرًا ونذيرًا بين يدي الساعة. من يطع الله ورسوله فقد رشد، ومن يعصهما فإنه لا يضر إلا نفسه ولا يضر الله شيئًا. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم: إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد عبدك ورسولك وصل على المؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات وبارك على محمد وأزواجه وذريته. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: أرحم أمتي بأمتي أبو بكر رضي الله تعالى عنه، وأشدهم في أمر الله عمر رضي الله تعالى عنه، وأصدقهم حياء عثمان رضي الله تعالى عنه، وأقضاهم علي كرم الله وجهه، وفاطمة سيدة نساء أهل الجنة رضي الله تعالى عنها، والحسن والحسين سيدا شباب أهل الجنة رضي الله تعالى عنهما، وحمزة أسد الله وأسد رسوله رضوان الله تعالى عنه وعن كل صحابة أجمعين. اللهم اغفر للعباس وولده مغفرة ظاهرة وباطنة لا تغادر ذنبا. الله الله في أصحابي لا تتخذهم غرضا من بعدي، فمن أحبهم فبحبي أحبهم، ومن أبغضهم فببغضي أبغضهم، وخير أمتي قرني ثم الذين يلونهم ثم الذين يلونهم. اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين، اللهم انصر المجاهدين المسلمين في كل مكان، اللهم أيد الإسلام وأنصاره، وأذل الشرك وأشراره. اللهم وفقنا لما تحب وترضى، واجعل آخرتنا خيرا من الأولى. اللهم انصر من نصر دين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم واجعلنا منهم، واخذل من خذل دين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ولا تجعلنا معهم. عباد الله رحمكم الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله العلي العظيم يذكركم، وادعوه يستجب لكم، ولذكر الله أكبر، والله يعلم ما تصنعون.
الله أكبر الله أكبر، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة، حي على الفلاح، قد قامت الصلاة، قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله.
الله أكبر. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. الله نور السماوات والأرض، مثل نوره كمشكاة فيها مصباح، المصباح في زجاجة، الزجاجة كأنها كوكب دري يوقد من شجرة مباركة مباركة زيتونة لا شرقية ولا غربية يكاد زيتها يضيء ولو لم تمسسه نار، نور على نور، يهدي الله لنوره من يشاء، ويضرب الله الأمثال للناس، والله بكل شيء عليم. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو، عالم الغيب والشهادة، هو الرحمن الرحيم. هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو، الملك القدوس السلام المؤمن المهيمن العزيز الجبار المتكبر، سبحان الله عما يشركون. هو الله الخالق البارئ المصور، له الأسماء الحسنى، يسبح له ما في السماوات والأرض، وهو العزيز الحكيم. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. أستغفر الله، أستغفر الله، أستغفر الله العظيم والتواب الرحيم، الذي لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم، وأتوب إليه، ونسألك توبة ومغفرة، إنه هو التواب الرحيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. اللهم أنت السلام، ومنك السلام، وإليك يعلو السلام، فحينا ربنا بالسلام، وأدخلنا الجنة دار السلام. تباركت ربنا وتعاليت يا ذا الجلال والإكرام، سمعنا وأطعنا غفرانك ربنا وإليك المصير، ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم، وسلام على المرسلين، والحمد لله رب العالمين. Thank you.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Imran Chunara, Africa Muslims Agency. Right now, the world is witnessing the mass destruction of life and intense suffering caused by the ongoing fighting in Afghanistan. Innocent human beings caught in the crossfire. Thousands of families are displaced. Africa Muslims Agency teams are on the ground right now, assisting through shelter, through food, through medicine, helping the injured. Many, many, many children are left without parents. Support the Africa Muslims Agency campaign to heal Afghanistan.